morning to everyone. Even I am going to talk about high energy materials, always I have a little bit fear factor when I am talking to our own people. I just want to have a fun quote here. This, how chemistry and physics of energy materials save the biology of a life. That is the philosophy of this talk. Some many of you may understand that why I am giving this kind of quote. Okay, that is out of thing. I will explain later. First of all, I want to thank Professor Sri, who really introduced me to this kind of research area. She is from University of Idaho in Moscow. Moscow is in USA, and she is at 85, but her energy level is that only 8.5 hours she will stay in the home. Evening time she will be working in the lab or office. That's how she still works. So I thank her to introducing me to this area. And also I thank that Sir Bhaskar, who really pulled me to give this talk, and also the student coordinator for arranging this thing. And all my academic past and present students, postdoc career, they really helped me developing this kind of research in my lab. And obviously, these are the references. I think I covered majority of the references. One of the major references is the DRDO website, also the Wikipedia, Google, all these things. And this book is very important. This has the medicines covered in this thing. And this is one of the articles written by these people from the Washington University. Okay. So based on that, the topic center. Obviously, DRDO is the one who is funding any of our research in our related to hand. So first thing that the definition for the unknown people who are not related to or not experienced with this kind of thing is that the energetic materials are substances, that is they are atoms or molecule or mixture of atoms or molecule that burn or combust and explode under certain condition. Okay. And like, you know, when you apply heat or shock, then only it will explode, otherwise they remain that way. So then in that process they decompose or rearrange extremely rapidly and produces gas. That is the one which is giving really energy. So actually this book, no? He turned this thing as a power pack material. In fact, earlier books, if you look at that, engineering books also, they refer this material as a propellant, explosive, or pyrotechnic. But you know, because of the various scenario in the world and changing situation, they don't want to use the term like, you know, explosive, propellant, all this thing. So this high energy material, the term is introduced in the scientific society. But you know, over the period of time, this, you know, these people explain that this is not really high energy material, they are the power pack material. This table really shows that if you burn gram of coal, and this is one of the famous science material, HMX, 1 gram of the HMX, what is the heat ever? See, this is so much high compared to this thing. But how long it takes? This is 60 seconds, is 10 power minus 6 seconds. Okay, so because of this thing, if you calculate in terms of watts, the power which we obtain from this burning of this material, that is this completely different here. Okay. The power is what is what? It's a within certain period of time how much shattering effect it can create. That makes a lot of difference here. So though this HMS is a molecule, organic molecule, which has a lot of energy stored, but the energy is compared to coal is very, very less. At least you can see at least 5 times less than that one. Right? But still the power of the HMS is completely, if I have 1 kilo of the not even 1 kilo, 100 gram of HMX, the building will have been shattered completely this room. Okay, but if I burn coal, maybe this thing will burn, but nothing will happen to the building. That's what is different here. Okay, so that's why he coined this as a power pack material. Okay, this is the some of the points. Normally, whenever we talk about high energy material, I always try to explain this thing. What kind of molecule? It's not the coal is going to really work there. And it's not the kerosene, it's not the petrol, they are not considered as a power pack material here. The molecules contain a big bond, capable of easy to nurture that. And the bond breaking and forming formation. You know, bond breaking that, and I explore the HMX, the bonds in the HMX is really breaking. But the products are formed, carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, nitrogen gas, right? The bond formation is supposed to happen there. So both should happen so easily, and that should be thermodynamically favorable. That I think no need to explain here. Many, almost all of you know that one. So unless this is thermodynamically favorable and spontaneous reaction, it's not possible to use it here. And obviously the kinetic favorable. So as I explained in the previous table, that no, this reaction should happen so fast in short period of time. And the negative heat of formation is the one which really represents that, you know, the molecule release of energy is exothermic process. Right? And important thing is that it should produce the gas molecule. Many such a molecule, for example, if you burn boron or aluminium, they produce a huge amount of energy in short span of time as well. But they are not going to produce the gas molecules here. Right? So then only when you have gas molecule, you can have the propellant or explosive power there. So that's also important. Then another thing is oxygen balance. The molecule, the burning process is what? Burning process is basically complete oxidation reaction. Almost all atoms in the molecule are supposed to oxidize to the corresponding oxidized product. Right? So aluminum to aluminum oxide, carbon to carbon dioxide, at least to carbon monoxide, right? And nitrogen will go as a nitrogen molecule, N2 molecule only. So that, you know, what is the nitrogen doesn't need oxygen here. But the all other things, hydrogen will go as a water. So all other things need oxygen. So where is some oxygen is given to this molecule? Whether within the composition what we are making, they have the oxygen, or they are taking from external source. External source is what? From atmosphere. So, okay, explosive compound can, explosive may happen within the atmosphere, no issue. But now the rocket is going out of the atmosphere also. Right, you know, Chandrayaan mission is going on. Maybe next, another 2 days it will be reaching, alert reach moon is going to land there, actually, right? So, where from there take oxygen? So, we have to supply the oxygen, some oxidizing material within the composition. So, this is the how much oxygen we are going to supply. That is also important parameter. And all this should be packed in the small possible area. So density of the also material also is very important here. Then the final wire is the, it should have the source sensitive. So this wire and this is the, you know, kind of contradicting you know, parameters here. I said it should be easy to rupture, it should be you know, explode easily, but at the same time should not be sensitive. So how you have to understand is that, you know, as long as I am telling you go explode, you should not explode. But you should be ready always there. Should be ready in condition so that when I trigger it, it should explode. But during the process or during the storage, it should not explode. So this is very, really a very narrow margin to work in this area. Okay, that is the challenging area. That's why you know, people are interested to do some research on this thing. This professor from this Michigan State University, they put a slide, I downloaded from the internet. The any compound, this is cellulose or nitrocellulose, they are similar compounds, just one derivative here, right? So they can combust, they can deflagrate, they can detonate. So combustion is just a burning phenomenon, nothing happens there. Energy will be released, heat will be produced, it's okay. But deflagration and detonation, you see, the products are same in both the cases, right? So the difference between these two is that the rate at which combustion step takes place. Especially, definitely compared to this thing, this will be very higher. And but deflagration is a controlled phenomenon. Kind of, other people tell cigarette burning is one of the examples. If you look at this thing from start from one side and burn to only other direction. So the burning trend moves from one side to other side continuously. But how fast it moves, that's the important thing. But detonation is like a smash. If you take a, you know, cook potato and smash it, you see that the energy of the impact is spread to the all part of the potato in simultaneously, three-dimensional. Right? The waves it follow spread to all part of the potato simultaneously. It, you know, breaks all area at a time. Right? That is the difference between the detonation and deflagration. So this material, when they deflagrate, or we create the condition for deflagration, so they can be used as a propellant. And when we create the condition for detonation, they are exposing material. That's a difference. but material can be same, material can be different as well. So when you come to this application of this material, these are all the very well known to all of us.
Okay.
This is the first, primary use of explosive material for defense purposes. And this is also very well known to all of us. This is one of the constructive application which is used in this space application. Different, again, here is that both are rocket. This is rocket, this is also rocket. But this rocket at the top of the this space generally, at top of this rocket, we have explosive material, then we call them as a missiles. When we top of the rocket, if you have a satellite, we just call them as a satellite. Sorry, a rocket actually. Or launch vehicle, that's what you say. So space application, this is used. They take the satellite and launch in the either polar orbit or geostationary orbit or low earth orbit. That's the job is over for that. But this will function mostly based on the solar energy. But still they store a little bit of energy in material here as well to correct the orbit level. And for example, this Chandrayaan is going, right? Chandrayaan 2 mission, the surface is going, but you would have planned that no orbital maneuvering, something like that. For that purpose, they store a little bit of this thing, but majority of the material drop is over and it is launched in any of these orbit there. But this thing just goes to target and then attack the target. So I'm not going to talk anything about this thing. These are very well known. So we will leave that, you can learn from any side. So my interest is that the constructive use of this this material. So you can keep watching these figures, space and satellites is the main constructive use. Mining and quarrying. So when you have open cast, it's called as open cast mining, there's underground mining also. They dig inside the earth and then go also. So anywhere, when you want to break many of the material at a time, they use this kind of small explosive material only. Construction application, if you want to dig the earth and then make the road, for example, if you go from here to Gachibowli to airport, the hill mountains are broken, right, to make the road. So that kind of places, they use this kind of thing, construction. And obviously going down deep inside the excavation for oil exploration, right, so they use this thing. And controlled demolition, when you have building in a confined area of the big city, one building you want to break it, this is they do these things, control this thing. And these are all some of the examples. This kind of thing happened in Chennai also. I have seen that tower which was there in Chennai, but it is now not there. Okay, so that was done like this thing only. And this is something different. It's avalanche control, but it's not common in India. But people, a place like, you know, Canada or the Idaho state in US, where we have huge amount of snow, where I live, where while working Professor Singh, that place is that you get 2 to 3 feet snow regularly for 3-4 months, actually. So they keep controlling and cleaning it. But what happens when the snow or lot of snow is accumulated in the mountain region, suddenly they break out. And when they pour into the earth surface, right, surface area from the mountain, it's a little bit dangerous. So to avoid that one, they go in the helicopter or something like that and throw small explosive material into that area. So it's broken very frequently. So they are not allowing them to accumulate loads of snow. So that, you know, it will not come out immediately, come down immediately, suddenly. So that kind of application also people use it. And the explosive welding, just welding material, this they are using. But I just want to touch about these two important topics, and before that I will talk about this also. So there are many lectures here in this hall about the Nobel laureate, but I think nobody talked about Nobel himself, right? So Nobel himself is created the high energy material, but he did not make this material. Later this was said by this person only, right? 1847. In 1867, he took this nitroglycerin and then combined with the diatomaceous air and created dynamic. That is where he earned lot of money, right? So in fact he died in 1896 itself, right? But he made huge amount of money. The trust was created. That is the trust he is giving to Nobel Prize, right? But we always talk about the Nobel Laureate, we forget about this person, right? So, but this entire Nobel Prize and the corresponding research coming out from the Nobel Prize is created by the invention in the high energy medium. That's what the important thing you should understand.
How did he die?
It's normal death. So it's very complicated synthesis, very complicated molecule, and then you know very tough to work in this very dangerous world. Of course, they are certain extent they are true. Simple example is the saccharomyces pigment. Everybody is looking for this material synthesis because this predicted to be highest possible energy release coming from this molecule, which will be better than RDX HMS, which is currently used in all over world. 10 years back, when I was interacting with some of the scientists from the HEMR laboratory in Pune, they said that, can you give the procedures for synthesis of this thing? I thought little surprised that what is that? You know, I know because I was working this thing, there are some reports already known. I looked at that and then downloaded this paper and then showed to them that, you know, the synthesis is already known, why don't we use it? But no, the comment is that, you know, kind of they did not use the word, but kind of chunk. This paper is useless. That's what the expression I got from that. The reason is that this involves such a beautiful synthesis. But what they say is that this is, they have made only millimole scale. What we are looking for in ton level. Okay. So this compound is, this synthetic method is not viable for practical application. So that is how these things are, you know, going on. But if you look at that, you know, how the really high-energy materials are used. This is the slide I used to show to our students in BSc, IMS students especially, even MSc also. This is a qualitative analysis lab. Right? So this is the flame test we do for the strontium. Right? So strontium, after defeating the concentrated hydrochloric acid and then platinum wire, if you show, it will show the beautiful red or reddish orange flames. That is what actually used in the pyrotechnics. Pyrotechnics is the firework is very well known for all of us actually. But this is the spillover application from the pyrotechnics. Yeah. So our beautiful colors comes from simple inorganic molecules, right? And the simple chemistry what you learn in the qualitative analysis lab as well. So that kind of chemistry only used in this kind of major application. So the first thing what I want to say is that the visual distress signal. So when ships are in high sea, if we say high sea, it means that deep inside the sea, like Pacific Ocean or somewhere, where there is no communication, no satellite can access that area, right? There is no radio communication, weather condition is so bad. So when they have some distress, how they give signal to the nearest possible people to rescue them? That is where the pyrotechnics started actually. So there are many approved methods, the strontium. Using strontium powder is the main approved method in all over the world for this purpose. So what they do, they fire a little bit of the compound, they produce smokes along with the strontium nitrate, it produces this color. So when they see these colors somewhere in the high sea, it means that somebody is looking for help. That is the signal given to that one. So this is only thing will work in the high sea. Of course, even color, the pyrotechnics, if this light, the colorful thing can be possible in night as well. Night as well as day. You can see the Diwali, the next month Diwali is coming, so you can see many things in the market, right? The same thing, basically they are coming from pyrotechnic used in the ship and this distress signal. If you look at the composition, almost all of them use the strontium nitrate only. This is the percentage of, since I just copy pasted this thing, I did not fill it, all these properly. This is the percentage of the strontium nitrate in the composition. You see, basically, in spite of having so much beautiful chemistry, but we use only very, very well-known, easily available chemistry for this kind of application. So you can see that some of the oxidizer like potassium chloride is mixed there, and then energetic fuel, aluminum, all these things also sometimes they mix it. Different company make different composition for also making color combination also. Okay, this is about this scene. Coming to the important part of the discussion is that I don't see the difference between these two behavior from our people, our society. So you see, nobody follows the traffic rule here. And many of you did not follow the safety rules in our school. Right? So the chaos happened in both the places here. Right? Because somebody did not follow the rule, what will happen to the other person? That's the important thing. Many of you know this car. It's my car, right? Beautiful car. So I love this car, okay. So I started in the 18th May this year. What happened? This guy who was in the third lane here without giving any signal, and he's not supposed to turn right here, and suddenly try to turn right. I was going here and he was in second lane, moved to third lane, so I thought he's taking left somewhere else. But he goes and then suddenly turns right here. Impact is, you know, is on my car only. I try my best with the impact. But I followed my rule with having all my seat belt, everything, with everything I followed at our rule. I hope I followed the speed limit as well. Because many places there is no speed limit clearly mentioned. But I used to drive 90 to 100 in the highway. But I guess that is the right speed limit that area. This is what happened to my car. But the topic for today's interest is that this is the important thing here. You see, how really helps to save the life here. Of course, this accident was minimized by sideway impact. So. This was useful, but that coupon is not really needed. If it was a head-on collision, it could have been really important here. So this is the airbag, car airbag, right? Many of you may be knowing this thing. If not, also you know that thing. So in fact, once this happened, within half an hour, my second daughter in fifth class, no, she is a very tuckety girl. Within half an hour, all this thing, we settled down and then sit somewhere after having the water. She came to me, "Daddy, what is this thing? What is inside?" Okay, that was the question she raised. I was a little shocked that moment she asked this question, because really I did not know exactly. I know some hiding video is there, and then mostly this that sodium was there, and then it could have created the nitrogen there. Okay, that's what I told, but you know, fifth class, I cannot explain everything. I said some gas will be produced and from the chemical reaction, this is happened. But after that, I saw that when this happened, I will show the next thing. Okay, before that, this slide shows that people having seat belt and only seat belt, and people having both seat belt and airbags fixed in the car. The how much it saved the life. There is a 46% reduction. This is the percentage of people who are all saved. Right? If 100 people involved in accident, almost this way 95% of the people are saved actually. But if you don't have the airbag, the saving ratio will be very less here. So it is the one which really saved that. We can say many examples. I also have seen somewhere in this road also 5-6 years back, they achieved a point. One guy just hit a bag there, and another guy from the back hit on this thing, but the airbag was not there. Actually, he died that space. But impact is that when you have this accident, your body moves suddenly. This happens in a fraction of a second. Right? I had only 2 seconds to react on that one. Right? So that seconds are important. That second, it goes and hit on the steering wheel, and that is where the people, that's why people die. So the airbag saves that people like this. So this is how this will come out. The time is crucial. The airbag must able to deploy the matter in milliseconds, right? Fraction of a second. But at the same time, it should not be deploying this airbag just before collision. That's a very, very important parameter here. And here you look at that. When you have this thing, seatbelt will be there. It will protect you. But apart from seatbelt, what happens, I noticed that myself, when you move with this thing, the seatbelt pulls you back. It tightens somewhere. That's the mechanical part here. But only here, right? but your face will move like this. There you get a neck injury. Right? So neck injury and also avoid the chest injury, not only belt, both places. This airbag will be displayed completely like this thing, protecting entire part of the body from the face to stomach. So to avoid heat on this thing. That is really stop the accident here. So the idea is the body of the driver should not hit on the airbag while it is still inflating. At the same time, the airbag cushion of the head or torso should be with air for maximum protection. So that means that it should come just after impact, but within millisecond. But also it should deflate immediately. Right, because I'll show the pressure, how much pressure inside this thing. If the so much pressure inside, that airbag is not an airbag. Doesn't behave like an airbag. It behaves as a stone. Right? That impact also will be very high there. So it will should come and it will should go down immediately also. So that should happen in fraction of time. That's how they designed this thing. Right? In fact, I noticed that when this happened, the airbag is deployed there, it covers the entire front of this. In fact, I scared a little bit because of the airbag, because it came to me and covered my face. I could not see anything, that movement. That is where the thing. Just 1 second before I could see that movement. But I tried to do like this thing. A lot of scratches was there. But after that, I was looking and thinking, what is this scratches? Why this is coming out from this? You know, airbag is a nylon bag. Right, nylon bag. So much of pulmonary chemistry also involved here. Right. So nylon bag. What is this scratch? Then I looked at all these things. Before that, what is this thing mechanism? There will be a airbag sensor system. There will be a what is that? Steel balls. Steel ball will be kept somewhere at the end of this thing. It is attached to a magnet. So it will be remaining there, but even if it is attached to the magnet, when you impact it, so this ball will be moved out from this. But the collision, how much energy, how strong it is attached to the magnet, how much impact, are not part of the chemistry. There are a lot of mechanical automobile engineering involved in that part. So anyway, they can easily design this thing. So impact, so once this happens, the ball, which is placed at this thing, it goes, moves up into this area, where actually the high-energy material circuit, sorry, buzzer is basically here, right? High-energy material circuit here, it goes and then the switch on the switch, it creates the explosion. That's how these things are happening. And then once electrical circuit is started, switched on, right? Electrical circuit is started, the rapid reaction will happen there and nitrogen gas is produced. Sorry, buzzer only creates nitrogen gas, right? But you see that everything put into nylon and any other polyamide polymers only here. Right. So all this thing happens within 40 milliseconds. So that is the important thing. That's what the clear definition is, a power packed material. So they release the gas or energy within that short period of time. But here the sodium azide is the compound which is producing the nitrogen gas, but it leaves the sodium inside that one. Okay, so then it contains the mixture of sodium azide, potassium nitrate, and silicon dioxide in that airbag. So what happens when this is triggered by the sensor at the 300 degrees Celsius needed for this thing to decompose to release the nitrogen gas? When this is decomposing nitrogen gas, side product is sodium. We can't leave sodium as such. Right? Apart from the accident, when even otherwise also, if some leakage happened in the car and goes to airbag, you will have problem, right? So that is also problematic here. So what they do that, they keep the potassium nitrate here. Sodium will react with the potassium nitrate and then K2O and NaO2O is formed, again it releases the nitrogen gas. So both the nitrogen will fill up this thing, but the signal, when this the signal comes from the sensor, it's electrical signal only. So its battery is operated there and produces the instantaneously 300 degrees Celsius. So this reaction happened. It produces nitrogen gas and sodium is further reacted with this thing, K2O and Na2O. But first period of the period metal oxide are highly reactive. These are all metal oxide in the first period of the periodic table, right? They are very highly reactive. We cannot leave them also because that is also the corrosive and also sometimes they may also explode as well. So to avoid that one, they keep this silicon dioxide and inside. Right. So this potassium oxide and the sodium oxide form react with silicon dioxide to form the aluminum silicate. This is basically glass. Right. All these things are happen within 40 milliseconds. Which one? Here?
Yeah, the reaction.
This one. This is the activation energy for reaction.
But the way you are telling is how much kinetic energy required to initiate the reaction?
No. See, actually, the difference is, I'll tell you the pressure and energy that next coming slides are there. Basically, this is the force of which working that depends on how fast the ball is moving and switching on the switches.
Okay.
One the switch on that gives the electrical signal. Electrical signal is that 300 degrees Celsius produced by the electrical signal. So that using the 300 degrees Celsius is just heating up the reaction. At the 300 degrees Celsius, this is we can say it's a kind of thermodynamic energy, endothermic process, right? Initially we have to supply energy, so it will reaction happen. But here this reaction is not a exothermic reaction. It should not be exothermic reaction as well, because it will spoil the airbag as well, right? So it releases the gas only, there is no energy here, right? That's what I have been repeated saying, power packed material. So the power is coming from the gas, not from the energy released from here, right? So that is how, so the aluminum silicate glass is produced. So that clearly explained why I had all the scratches in my hand, right? So when I tore this thing, and immediately the bag also deflated, right? So when it's deflated, deflated means what? It became beyond some pressure, there will be small holes or wall kind of thing kept in the nylon bag there, and that they are also release as that beyond some pressure, right? So that they release that pressure, and then the material inside, gas, say glass material which is coming out this thing, so that really cut my hand. Okay, so this is the beautiful chemistry really happened in this thing. Now, how much of
Is the bag there suffering any loss?
Yes.
Because there are a lot of cases of the sodium burning in the face.
Yeah. So that's why that, I mean, the earlier bag was like that one. Sodium burning happened because of this issue. Now they have this composition. So this is not this sodium oxide and potassium nitrate, all these things. Finally, no sodium will be there. The reaction happened so fast, final product is only nitrogen and silica glass. There's two only products out of this thing. Okay, so many patterns are there, right? They will not disclose a real composition.
You are getting this kind of vaccinal detail,
sir? Yes. I think I'm waiting for the bill. I think 22,001 for one bag. That's what I'm waiting for, that bill. Okay. But this is very important. Now, actually, last year, the government of India said that all cars should come with the airbag, at least two airbags, one for the driver, one for the passenger sitting next to the driver. This is mandatory now. Even small auto cars also coming with this kind of airbag nowadays. It's a rule now. Okay. So, but another thing, how the chemistry really helps here, right? A simple gas lamp, right? How much of the sodium that I am supposed to keep in this? The gas law says that assuming the ideal behavior of the inert gas produced here, nitrogen, right? Ideal behavior, how much sodium oxide I'm supposed to keep inside. Then I can calculate about the other material there, right? So this is the number of moles. Gas constant temperature can be assumed as room temperature here, right? So if I know the pressure and volume, I can calculate how many number of moles of sodium oxide probably needed to fill that bag with that much pressure, right? So that is it, can be obtained from the gas law here. So there is supposed to be a little bit physics here. That's why the first quote I said that chemistry and physics are kind of material, right? So this is physics also needed here. So assuming that the airbag supported it back, what, how this thing airbags will be, kind of the plate like shape of this thing. Round, I'm getting the name of
pillow shape.
Pillow kind of shape, right? Pillow shape, but I'm thinking about chemistry word. Yeah, the pillow like thing, right? So one part of the pillow is fixed in this thing. Right? What is the chemistry like? Some rhombic structure, really. So pillow, you see that one side of pillow is fixed there. other side of the pillow, other ball of the pillow supposed to move from the fixed place, right? So then you know the once it is moved, what is the ball length? That is can be defined, right? That is defined one. Yeah. So then, so the wall. Let us assume that the velocity of this thing at the beginning is this one, zero velocity. Then when move to the distance of d, that is the thickness of the air band here, and then velocity reaches some value here, like no, this many meters per second. Because I said that it should happen at 30 milliseconds, right? From that we can calculate that how much velocity is supposed to be there. When you put this thing, all this thing, acceleration from the basic equation of linear motion, you can calculate the acceleration. A is acceleration here, d is this thing, initial velocity, final velocity, d is the distance between the thickness of the air bag, and acceleration is required for this thing, can be calculated here. Right. Once you know the acceleration, you know again another physics law is very, very well known school day law is that the Newton's law, force equal to ma. You know acceleration, mass, you can assume that you know what is the mass of the air bag, right? The bag is made of nylon bag, normally around 2 to 3 kilo mass, right? So that is the weight of the air bag alone, right? So that to push that bag, how much this energy is required, force is required, that force can be calculated. Once you know the force, and you can calculate the pressure from this equation, right? This is the area of the surface area of the central part of the air bag, right? How much energy force is required to push that one. So you can put into this equation, you calculate the pressure needed for that one. So what is that? You can now calculate that, and the volume is the volume of the airbag which is designed by the manufacturer. So you put the pressure and volume, you can calculate that how much of moles of the sodium azide is required to fill that airbag within that short period of time. Right, so that can be easily calculated now using this thing. So really the simple formula in the physician chemistry helped us to calculate the how much amount is required. When you put it, but it is only gauge pressure, right? But it has to move against the atmosphere pressure. So that's all we also added. So this gives the absolute pressure of that, how much pressure should develop. So you substitute this value into gas law. So you can get the how many moles of sodium azide is needed for this thing to happen. So that's about the airbag chemistry. I think I have crossed 25 minutes, right? Yeah. So another maybe 5 to 6 minutes, 10 minutes also. So this is the research direction because as Professor Tansai mentioned, if you don't have other things or even the sodium azide is kept in case of accident, not involving the pollution accident, in the leakage, something like that. So we create so much trouble here. The hydrosol, I forget the name, this acid is produced there, and sodium hydroxide also there is introduced to people. That's why many people working, these are still development level only, they make high nitrogen content molecule. They are not supposed to release the high energy, heat energy, but they are supposed to release a lot of nitrogen alone. Here, that's what people are trying to do. When you research, in fact, one of the molecules, we also synthesized long back, but anyway, we could not go further on that. This is about the research direction this year. Next topic is that how the people are, the pilot is saved from this. This is the one of the fighter aircraft produced by India, designed and produced by India, Hindustan Aeronautic Limited. It's called, named as a Tejas, right? It's a majestically parked somewhere in the Himalayan region. A completely indigenous aircraft here. But olden days, especially the World War time, right? Olden days, you don't have this part in the aircraft. It will be open. Right? This is called as a canopy. So what is the use of this canopy? Very, very nicely can be understand that unless you have some protection when the flight is going, the aircraft is going the high velocity, right? High speed in the atmosphere. You need to have some protection. That just for that protection only this is there. But it's something similar to windshield of the car. Windshield of the car is acrylic polymer. Again, polymer chemistry, without polymer chemistry, nothing is happening here, right? So windshield of the made of polymer, acrylic polymer. Why I'm repeatedly saying the polymer, there was a call by the government of India to let us fight against the plastic. But that, you should not misunderstand that. That is not for this kind of plastic. That is for one-time use plastic. It's like plastic cover, plastic bottle, where you use and throw without proper care. So that kind of plastic, only not for this kind of plastic, right? So that you have to be clear in differentiating those three. Right? So this is the one which is covering this thing. If you look at this GLE website, you can get this information, this analysis thing. So this is what, how this happened. In case of emergency, when the aircraft catches fire, the fire sitting inside should come out. Here, this image such that it was open. They can jump out with the parachute, right? But now, because the canopy is covering that one, but it's related to, almost same to like a car windshield in the car, right? So we just, we colloquially say car glass, right? It's not glass, it's a windshield, known as a windshield. It's acrylic acid, acrylic polymer. Yeah. So, but thickness and then the strength of the glass, what we are using in the car, supposed definitely very, very less compared to what we are using here. So in car, you can see that two seat at the headrest in the seat easily removed. One of the reason why they keep it like that, in case something happened, if you want to break it, if you remove it easily and hit it, it will break all the glass in that car. That's the idea of the car. But same thing is not possible here, because this thickness is very high here. So how they people do is that, so something called canopy severance system here. So, and also this movable chair is kept there. So that is how this thing, this both will be happening simultaneously, like a, you know, what I was telling about the airbag here. So this should break at the event when they want to escape, the pilot want to escape, right? At the same time, this will be launched out from the aircraft here. That's how this will work. So the, how this is breaking, right? So that is where the high dependent. Before that, this how this is molded basically. This is one sheet, right? The one sheet is put into molding, like this thing is called as a the vacuum forming. So there will be small wall connector to the vacuum. So first they melt it to the level that it can, you know, flexible, it become flexible. Not melting, it's needed to level so that it become flexible and put it to shape like whatever is needed there, and then vacuum mold it here. That's how this canopy have to do. So there's no joint, nothing is there, right? So when you want to make this thing, canopy severance part is called as a canopy severance part, consists of simple secondary explosive and event of ejection, the explosive part is activated first and shatter the canopy, right? The canopy is removed and immediately this ejection of the pilot is launched, the ejection wheel of the pilot is launched out of this thing. So this the critical system, the GSS system is that, the transfer line, explosive transfer line. So, and it should also happen within the detonation speed of the this many meter per second, 6,000 meter per second. That's the important thing here. So anyway, this is the typical composition, and you can, just for information I'm giving here, the RDX and the this diacrylic surface, all these things are used for the first phase. Many such composition used by the American and British people. So slowly they improving on all these things, that's how the things are developed. But these are all very, very well-known simple molecules in the organic chemistry or polymer chemistry, that's what they use it. And they make this something called plastic explosive. The plastic explosive comes in this kind of small boxes as well. So basically you would have seen that clay bits are used to play, right? Something like that explosives are made, right? So this is pulled and make as a small card and then kept on the, this area, this joints, that's what we call as a, the card, right? The card, so they kept in that one. So when this explosion had triggered, so immediately the canopy will explode and then the pilot will be able to come out. So this is what I want to convey today. But before closing this thing, I just try to show one of the video.
Mike.
she is escaping at the bottom. How this kind of surveillance system will happen, right? So you see how fast these things are happening. So the chemicals what we are using, they should respond. I could not get the English translator slide video. This was only simple video which gave short time within 1 day. That's what the my idea. Okay, so this is what I want to convey today is that the canopy surveillance system is again small transfer cars are kept at the bottom of edges of the canopy. So they explode instantaneously, allow that the canopy is broken and then pilot is ejected from this. This is the test done in the surface level, but the same thing will happen in the sky as well. So with this thing, I'll just share this thing. Show to you because I started with the road accident as well, right? So this is the recent advice from the traffic police Hyderabad. You can save a lot of money if you follow the safety rules here, right? And also this is advice from the School of Chemistry. We can save a lot of money if you follow the safety rules here. So that
goes in here.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes.
That is what that is better actually. So follow the safety rules both in the road and in the lab. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for this rich power pack talk. So our session is now open for questions. Please.
On slide 15, you showed this orange cloud coming from this ship.
Yes, yes.
Right.
Yes.
The reason is, of course, the color identification is easy, and you said that satellite communication, etc., are not possible.
Yeah.
I mean, even present day, it's not possible.
Present day, I mean, talk
these,
of
these technologies were developed, I mean, like during the first world war, second world war.
Yes, yes. Present day also they are using here.
They are really using, but I just want to know whether they.
Yeah, it's combination of this thing. Mm-hmm. So some places still the radar signal
because
is not
signaling
possible.
Goes. I mean, nowadays the signal goes from the place where the ship or whatever which gives a signal goes to satellite and comes back in the satellite to receive it.
Yeah.
Is that not possible?
It's possibly possible.
Possibly possible.
They talk about the internet based, based communication, all this thing they talk about. But sometimes weather condition is bad, and also they can communicate to only the controller. Right. But somebody may be near to them, they may not have direct communication with them. So combination of the signal is still used. Apart from that thing, this system is not only for this thing. Even you would have seen the US road accident, if your car has damage or this thing, pull it and then keep this thing, that kind of thing.
Yeah.
Everywhere
is possible. That is also one of the reasons, Bermuda Triangle, weather condition.
Fails
all the modern communication technology.
Yes. Many places that
thing works there.
No, sir, still they are using sodium azide.
Yes, of course. Yeah.
No, but I don't know because I remember when I read, they say now they replace with other chemicals.
No.
Still they are using airbag.
Japanese technology, Sushi, Maruti Suzuki, right? So still it is definitely used sodium azide only because I could see all the reaction really happened there with the glass particle on my hand, right? So I guess that this is still they use it.
Okay, I have a question, the traffic rules, the police,
yeah,
because I want to one more time see.
which actually applies to you.
See, the last one, with the license, why they are, with the driving license, why...
You can say it.
You can say it.
All it is telling, every day you are driving the driving license, you add up how much money you are saving in a year.
But actually what is missing is overspeed is missing, 1,000 rupees filing. This is what I got from the traffic website actually. This is from our Hyderabad traffic police website.
This is a very positive kind of way of advertising. Usually they will say you will be fined. Same thing is said in a different way. It's more positive.
Why they are produced, I mean, planning to put in many boards all over the city, many places, like this kind of boards, so that it is attracting people.
But actually,
they plan to implement from day after tomorrow, September 1.
Actually, we have to talk to the government because I have several photographs, videos where the traffic police even standing on the jeep.